My name is Than. We're on a dam, six figures, no suit. Watch and build.
Hi, my name is Josh Timmert. I'm the project manager for Nicholson Construction out here at the Prairie Du Sac Dam. We're installing micropiles across the dam as a means of basically underpinning and stabilizing the dam from the original wood timbers that it's founded on. There's tens of thousands of wood timbers that the dam was originally built. And basically over time, them have deteriorated from the water, resulting in potential failure of the dam eventually if they continue to erode. We're installing total 984 micropiles to basically replace all the wooden timbers, and when we're done, the design itself is set to where there's no need for any soils, timber piles, anything else. It can completely be supported on these micropiles. About 18 degrees, so challenging today versus our normal working conditions, but we're working through it. So a micropile, in its context, there's several types. In this application, we're using soil piles. So basically what we're doing is a duplex method. There's an outer drill string and a casing that gets drilled down to depth. And there's an inner rod that basically flushes all your cuttings back up through the drill. And then once it's down to the tip elevation, we fill it with a neat cement grout. It's basically just cement and water. Once that's done, we set a center bar. In this case, it's a number 24. So a pretty big, 3-inch rebar that's going down the center, but full length. Once that's set, we then pull up the casing, leaving 20 foot still in the ground.
Check, check. Okay. 1, 2, 1, 2. Okay. I got busting some beasties or something. We drill down, we use a 20 foot starter casing with 10 teeth on it, continuous teeth, cut through the overburden with a roller bit head. We descend down 35 feet until we hit the bottom of the gallery, and we descend another 60 feet after that.
We're about to enter what we call the gallery, which is the inside of the dam. We've cut a 6x6 opening into the dam rollway to allow us access. Let's go on in. So here we are in the gallery on the west side to see where the casing has come through the rollway of the dam and then is descending down. You'll see a metal frame that the casing is being guided into the location of the micropile.
My name is Joseph Smotherman. I work for Nicholson Construction. I'm a driller. These new drill rigs we're getting nowadays are all remote control, so you have a whole bunch of switches. They all feel the same, not like a regular drill, a good drill that you got a cab you can set in. We're out in the elements all day long. The remote controls are nice because you can get closer to where you're actually working and see what you're doing versus the cabs. You're limited to your area you have to work in. With the remotes, you can get up there and actually see what you're doing a whole lot better. You don't have to trust anybody else but yourself.
This job in particular is very unique. The best of my knowledge and other people involved, this has never been done. Micropiles themselves aren't the most unique type of construction, but to this scale, 984 across the dam, drilling through the dam with several operations across it, that's what really makes it unique versus a typical project.
Barge work poses a couple of different things. I mean, obviously you've got fall from heights, you've got water nearby, so you want to wear PFDs. you're on a floating surface with a very large piece of equipment drilling through a dam in three different levels. You can easily become bound in any one of those levels, 35 feet through those levels, but in all total, 92 feet in depth. If the barge is to sway or move or be drifted off course, different challenges for sure to be watchful of.
The team we have out here at Prairie Du Sac is Nicholson as a GC. We have a couple other subcontractors doing small scopes of work. I mean, we are a pretty close family. A lot of these guys I've worked with on several projects. Even in the 5 years I've been with Nicholson, I've worked on probably five or six different jobs with most of these guys. So we have, you get to know each other. It does become a pretty close-knit group of guys. And even afterwards, myself and a lot of the guys, we have campers up at the campground and get together after work, make group dinners and talk, 30 minutes of work afterwards, and then we shut her off and it's back to, life outside of work.
After work, everyone hangs out back at the hotel. One we're staying at now will even give you a beer a night. So that's a nice way to wind down and everyone get together and talk about what happened and, talk about life outside of work. A lot of us are on the road, so that's a good way to have a support group with you every day.
No, I don't think this job is for everyone. I think you got to have a certain toughness about you, a certain resilience-ness about you. It hasn't been too bad for myself, and definitely opened up some opportunities for the family that they would not normally have.
I do own a suit. Couldn't tell you the last time I wore it. It probably doesn't fit anymore. It was probably when I was in high school or something, or maybe for my first job interview. It wasn't on the job, I can tell you that, that's for sure.
No, I would say the last time I wore a suit was probably at my brother's wedding. Or my sister's wedding. See, I don't know.
I've never worn a suit, and I don't plan to, because I don't need it.